What's up, guys? Welcome back to the TenorShare channel. It's so convenient to unlock the iPhone with a touch or face ID, but that becomes part of the reason we forget our passcode. After several failed attempts, the iPhone is disabled message shows up on the screen. Fortunately, we can still unlock it in iTunes. But does that mean we can just connect them and start unlocking? Not exactly. iTunes won't detect it right away. What we have to do is put the device into recovery mode first. If you have iPhone 8 or later, including iPhone SE 2020, press and quickly release the volume up and down button successively, then press and hold the side button until you see the recovery mode screen. If you have iPhone 7 or 7 Plus, press and hold the side and volume down button simultaneously until you see the recovery mode screen. If you have iPhone 6s or earlier, press and hold the power and home button at the same time until you see the recovery mode screen. Now iTunes should recognize your phone and gives you the option to update or restore. We select the restore. iTunes will be downloading the latest iOS firmware. After that, it'll start restoring. Well done. So that's it. If you have difficulty using iTunes, 4Key will be the best alternative for you. It offers a step-by-step guide for all devices to enter recovery mode, not just iPhone, but iPad, iPod as well. It also lets you download the firmware to anywhere at your choice. This could be a lifesaver when you run out of space on your C drive. Once got the firmware, you can start the unlocking process anytime you want. Just like that. Now you can go ahead and set it up. Choose Restore from Backup to get your data back. And then, all your applications and files will be returning to your home screen. If you use Find My across your devices, you don't actually need iTunes or an USB connection anymore. You can do it wirelessly on iCloud.com. Just sign in your Apple ID. Go to Find iPhone. Click All Device on the top bar. Select the device we are going to unlock, and then proceed with the erase. After customizing all these settings, the erase will begin. This is faster because no firmware is involved in the process. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. If you think this video is helpful, don't forget to share it with your friends. See you.